Now take your book to split the words monuments, monuments. You should read along with me. Temples, palace, mosques, tombs, forts, minars and minarets are called by the collective name monuments. The sultans of Delhi introduced a new type of architecture. The monuments they built had arches, domes and minarets as the main features. The inscriptions in these monuments contain rich information which can be used to construct history. The medieval Khajuraho monuments, Madhya Pradesh, and the temples in Konark, Odisha, and the Dilwara, Mount Abu, Rajasthan, constitute valuable sources to understand the religion-centered culture evolution in northern India. Temples in Tanjavur, Brahadeshwara, Gangaikonda Cholapuram, Dharasuram symbolizes the magnificent structure the later Chola built in Tamil Nadu. Vithala and Virupaksha temples at Hampi similarly speak of the contribution of Vijayanagar rulers, 15th century. Quatul Islam Masjid, Motki Masjid, Jama Masjid, Fatehpur Sikri Darha, all in around Delhi and Charminar, Hyderabad, are the important mosques belonging to the medieval times. The forts of historical importance are Agra Fort, Chittur Fort, Gwalior Fort and Delhi Red Fort, as well as the forts of Daulatabad, Aurangabad, the Firoz Shah Kotla, Delhi, Palace in Jaipur, Jaisalmer and Jodhpur signify the greatness of the Rajput dynasty that wielded enormous power from these places. Qutub Minar and Alai Darwaza, the tombs of Iltutmish, Balban and all the Mughal rulers are other prominent structures recognized as valuable sources of information. Cities in drawing such as Firozabad and Tughlabad in North India and Hampi in South India remind rich repositories of the history of medieval India. Coins. The picture and the legend on the coins convey the names of kings with the titles and portraits, even places, dates, dynasties and logos. The composition of metals in the coins gives us information on the economic condition of the empire. Mention of kings' achievements like military conquest, territorial expansion, trade links and religious faith can also be found in the coins. Next page. Muhammad Ghori had stamped the figure of Goddess Lakshmi on his gold coins and had his name inscribed on it. This coin tells us that this early Turkish invader was in all likelihood liberal in religious outlook. Copper jewels are available for the study of the period of the Delhi Sultans. Silver tanka, introduced by Iltutmish, Alauddin Galji's gold coins, Mohammed bin Tughlaq's copper token currency or indicative of coinage, as well as the economic prosperity or otherwise of the country of the time. Do you know a jital contain 3.6 grams of silver? 14 jitals were equal to 1 silver tanka. Religious literature. Devotional movement in South India and later in North resulted in the development of bhakti or devotional literature. The Chola period was known as the period of devotional literature and works such as Kamba Ramayanam, Saikila Periya Puranam, Nalaira Divya Prabandham, composed by 12 Alvars and compiled by Nadamuni. Devaram composed by Appar, Sambandar and Sundarar and compiled by Namiyandar Nabi. Manikavasaka Thiruvasagam, all were scripted during the Chola's time. Jayadev Geeta Govindam, 12th century, was a follow-up of the Bhakti movement in South India. Kabir Das, a 15th century mystic poet, also had an influence on the Bhakti movement in India. Now, take a material to split the words. Second Roman, first cuisine, answer in detail. First cuisine, describe the different types of coins introduced by the rulers of Delhi Sultanate. The picture and the legend on the coins convey the names of kings with the titles and portraits, even places, dynasties and logos. The composition of metals in the coins gives us information on the economic conditions of the empire. First point, once again, the picture and the legend on the coins convey the names of kings with the titles and portraits, events, places, dynasties and logos. Second point, the composition of metals in the coins gives us information on the economic condition of the empire. Third point, mention of kings' achievement like military conquest, territorial expansion, trade links and religious faith can also be found in the coins. Third point, mention of kings' achievements like military conquest, territorial expansion, trade links and religious faith can also be found in the coins. Fourth point, Muhammad Ghori has stamped the figure of goddess Lakshmi on his gold coins and had his name inscribed on it. Muhammad Ghori had stamped the figure of goddess Lakshmi on his gold coins and had his name inscribed on it. Next point, these coins tells us that this early Turkish invader was in all likelihood liberal in religious outlook. This coin tells us that this early Turkish invader was in all likelihood liberal in religious outlook. Copper jewels are available for the study of the period of Delhi Sultans. A jewel contained 3.6 grams of silver. 48 jittals were equal to 1 silver tanka. Once again, a jittal contained 3.6 grams of silver. 48 jittals were equal to 1 silver tanka. Next question, the composition of metals in coins is indicative of the economic prosperity of the empire substantiate. Metals like gold and silver are precious and rare elements. They are shiny, strong and have high economic value. The composition of metals in the coins gives us information on the economic condition of the empire. If such metals are used in coins in an empire, it indicates its economic prosperity. Once again, first point, metals like gold and silver are precious and rare elements. They are shiny, strong and have high economic value. The composition of metals in the coins gives us information on the economic condition of the empire. If such metals are used in coins in an empire, it indicates its economic prosperity. The king's achievements like territorial expansion trade links, religious faith can also be found in the coins. The coins are the most universal embodiments of money. The king's achievements like territorial expansion, trade links, and religious faith can also be found in the coins. The coins are the most universal embodiments of money. Okay, second Roman 1 and second question. These two question, you should thorough this question, write neatly, take a photo and send your answer through WhatsApp. Okay, thank you students. See you in next class.